August 1994, the NWA Eastern Championship Wrestling title holder, the franchise Shane Douglas, wins the NWA World title, but throws it down at the ECW Arena and proclaims the ECW title, the Extreme Championship Wrestling Heavyweight Championship of the World. Hostile City Showdown 1995, April 15th at the ECW Arena. Woman, Nancy Sullivan, nails the franchise behind the knee, and a new world champion is crowned in the beer-drinking, cigarette-smoking, cane-swinging, hardcore icon, the Sandman wins the gold. But the Sandman is upset at the arena by Mikey Whipwreck, whose title reign is cut short on December 9th, 1995, as he is eliminated in a three-way dance by the hardcore icon, the Sandman, and the number one contender, none other than Steve Austin. With Whipwreck out of the way, the Sandman and Steve Austin, two beer-drinking anti-heroes, collide in the middle of the ring, and it's the Sandman, scoring the pinfall over Steve Austin in a stone-cold upset to become a two-time World Heavyweight Champion. But in January 1996, Raven, having just lost his girlfriend, Beulah McGillicuddy, to Tommy Dreamer, DDTs the Sandman for the pin and the world title. In an Ultimate Jeopardy tag team match, the Sandman scores the pinfall over Raven's lackey, Stevie Richards, to become a three-time ECW World Heavyweight Champion. But just over a month later, in one of the most controversial matches in ECW history, the Poet of the Macabre, Raven, regains the belt he never lost in a barbed wire match. It was at our very first pay-per-view, Barely Legal, April 13th, 1997, that Raven lost the gold to the living legend, Terry Funk. But Funk would lose the belt later that year in the most violent match in ECW history, Born to Be Wired, to the suicidal, homicidal, genocidal Sabu, who lost the belt the very next week, Hardcore Heaven 97, to the franchise Shane Douglas, whose manager, Ravishing Rick Rude, double-crossed the franchise at the Madhouse of Extreme in Queens, New York City, and Bam Bam Bigelow walks away with the World Heavyweight title, breaking up the triple threat. The franchise regained the gold at the November to Remember 1997 in his hometown of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. But the trials and tribulations of being the world champion took its toll on Shane Douglas, and he was choked out in Kissimmee, Florida, at guilty as charged by Taz. But Taz was defeated at Anarchy Rules 1999 by Mike Awesome and FMW champion Masato Tanaka. It was an impromptu three-way dance at the Odeum in Chicago, and Mike Awesome not only defeated the ECW champion Taz, but the FMW champion Masato Tanaka to become the undisputed heavyweight champion of the world. But Tanaka came back in Nashville, Tennessee, on December 17th, 1999, Tanaka pins Awesome for the World Heavyweight title. It was the final show of the millennium, December 29th, 1999, the Westchester County Center, White Plains, New York. Mike Awesome gets the gold back from Tanaka. And then, Indianapolis, Indiana, the only interpromotional match in modern-day wrestling history. ECW's Tommy Dreamer gets revenge on Awesome with a DDT. Awesome had appeared on WCW's Monday Nitro. Taz returns from the WWF and makes Awesome tap. WWF's Taz chokes out WCW's Mike Awesome with ECW's Tommy Dreamer's help in Indianapolis. Then, April 22nd, 2000, Cyber Slam at the ECW Arena. The innovator of violence, Tommy Dreamer, challenges his mentor, Taz, for the ECW World Championship. Tommy Dreamer wins his first ECW World Heavyweight title at Cyber Slam 2000. An event of such epic proportions that even Dreamer's longtime nemesis, Raven, buried the hatchet with Tommy Dreamer in front of the entire ECW arena as Francine, who had left Dreamer for Raven, looked on. But then ECW history took an interesting turn. Just incredible, canes Tommy Dreamer in the eye and brutally attacks Raven, taking him out with That's Incredible. An impromptu title match is preceded by Just Incredible throwing down the World Tag Team Championship, dissolving the Impact Players. Tommy Dreamer takes on Just Incredible at the ECW Arena, but Francine is in on the scam. Just Incredible hits That's Incredible, the Tombstone Piledriver, on Tommy Dreamer, and a new World Heavyweight Champion is crowned. Tommy Dreamer never got a chance to wear the belt. Just Incredible wins the gold. But this past weekend in St. Paul, Minnesota, referee Danny Daniels was gonna screw Jerry Lynn out of his opportunity to become the World Heavyweight Champion. The Tombstone Piledriver. One, two, and then the original referee for the match, New Jack, who had been jumped by Justin and Rhino in Mississauga, Ontario, Canada, returned. New Jack took out Danny Daniels. Jerry Lynn hits a cradle tombstone, and a new world champion is crowned in Jerry Lynn.